I'm Alien St. Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about agent tags. A lot of people may want to use Mesh Central alongside other pieces of software. In that case, if you have two different software, you may want to be able to match devices that are in Mesh Central with devices in another piece of software. Or let's suppose you have a lot of devices and you can't tell which one is which anymore and you need some help. Well, agent tags can help with both of these situations. So let's take a look at that feature. So I'm going to start with my trusty developer server. It's running on my local computer. I also have this browser here open to that server. And I have an agent running on this computer too, and it's called Central right here. So, you know, the server, this browser connected to the server, and the agent are all running on this computer that you're looking at now. And so, of course, I can take a look at this computer and so on. Okay, so what are agent tags? Well, those are a little piece of a little file that you put inside the agent folder. So I'm going to bring up here the folder for where the agent is installed. So C program files mesh agent. And this is the typical three files you'll see. The DB file containing various information about the agent that the agent keeps. The executable, of course, that's self-updating. And then you have the MSH file, which is a text file that tells the agent where to connect to. So in addition to these three files, I can create a new file. And actually what I'm going to do is create a new file like this. I'm going to create a new text document and drag and drop it here in this folder. And what you want to do is create a text file that's called exactly the same name as the mesh agent executable, but instead of exe, you're going to put dash dot tag at the end. So there you go. So mesh agent dot tag, and just for safety or to be safe, let's put the same capitalization here. So then what you're going to do is edit this. And I'm going to type it, for example, this is a sample tag. But this could be like an asset tracking, employee number, or anything that you want to uniquely identify this device by. Okay, so once I have this, I'm going to click on this central device. This is of course, this agent here. And what I'm going to do is restart the agent. So I'm going to go right here and say restart. And now, when the agent is going to stop, it's going to reconnect. And as soon as it reconnects, the agent, every time it starts up, will read this tag file and send it to the server. So now you can see agent tag, and you can see the tag right there. So what's nice about this is I can go back to my list of computers, and I can type a tag sample. And so it will show me all the computers that have the word sample inside their agent tag. Now, it's important to realize that this is not the same as the tags here, the server tags. So you can set those, of course, on the server side, and then you can search them by doing tag Bob, and then you'll see that, or tag Joe, or you know, whatever, and that will, you know, show you only the devices with that tag. So server-side tags or normal tags are different than agent tags. And so agent tags here are really reserved for tags that are set by the agent. Also, it's important to note that this file will have one line, and it have up to 1K in size. So 1 kilobyte in size. After that, it's truncated. So you can put anything you want. And of course, if I say comma modified like this, save it. Now I'm going to restart the agent. And as soon as the agent restarts, it's going to connect back and you should see the agent tag be modified. There you go with the update. So that's wonderful. So again, you can see how this can be useful for other applications that are embedding the mesh agent inside these other applications. You may want to put your unique identifier there, or maybe you have different asset IDs or stuff for computers. What you do is when you install the agent, you create this tag file. And when it connects, it reports back. And it's just so much more easier to track the computers based on the tag files. I think, let's see, I may be able to Let's see, agent tags. Yeah, agent tags not here yet. Okay, so now that we have that done, what I want to do is go back and show you an advanced version of agent tagging. So this is the basic one, and it's super useful, but there's something else you can do. Now I'm going to show you this text file here for a moment. So ignore the rest of the screen. What you can do is you can also, in the agent tag file, specify more information. So you can put in the agent tag file things like the name that you want the server to know this computer as. So for example, my central computer, and then my description. And you can also put tags like super computer and basic computer. Actually, no space here. Okay, so now I've put these extra lines. So server name, server description, and server tags. And what will happen now is that the agent will send this information to the server, and it should modify the name, the description, and the server tags with this information. Now, the thing is, sometimes you don't want to allow this. In fact, by default, this is not allowed. These three options here are not allowed by default. If you want to allow them, you're going to have to go in the domain section of your config.json, and you're going to have to add an agent tag section, and you're going to have to set server name, server description, and server tags, and you're going to have to say what the server should do when it receives that information. So 0 means ignore, 1 means set, 2 means set if empty, and then the third one is append, so add any existing tags that don't already exist. So here in the background, I've already set my config.json to 111 here. So set for the name, description, and tags. So I've already done that. But what you will need to do is set that in the config.json, restart your Mesh Central server so that now the Mesh Central server will know what to do. Again, by default, this is 000. So by default, all of these are ignored. But I've set them for my server to 1. So now I'm going to save this, and I'm going to restart the agent. Restart. And now what you should see when the agent reconnects is that a lot of things will change suddenly. Boom. So now the computer name has changed, the description has changed, and also the server-side tags have changed. Now, in addition to this, of course, the agent tag, if I had changed that, would also have changed. But now what's going on is that this file is controlling what information is being displayed by the server, the description, the name, and so on. So this is super useful if you you kind of trust all the computers that are connected to your server, and you want to allow the agent to set all that information when it connects to the server. So, and that's the syntax you would use. So what you would typically do is create a tag file, fill it up with what you want, install the agent, put the tag file, you know, the right place, and start up the agent and have that all set up. And so now you can see here, my computer has this name. So you can probably see how interesting this can be. Okay, so hopefully that was useful. Agent tags, super useful for helping you track your computers, and also super useful if you want to pair or match up computers in Mesh Central to computers in a different piece of software. Hopefully that helped. Thank you very much.